Hello viewers, this is the pouch that I have made using Crochet. Today I will be teaching you how to make this kind of a pouch. So now I have selected a sandal color wool. It is available in all the shops. And first you need to buy a zip. This is also available easily. First, you should measure the length of the zip and you should make the crochet of this little more than the zip's size. Only then you can make a pouch by attaching this zip to it. Okay, so let's start. This is the crochet needle and it is slightly bent in the front. And the size mentioned here is number 13. Now let's start. For that, let's keep this away now. First, you have to make a loop. So general loop, how you make using a rope, same method. Just a small loop like this. And now bring it forward and like this. This kind of loop, I'm sure many of you may be knowing. Now, make sure that the loop is not too tight because now you're going to insert this needle over here and tighten the loop. Now with your middle finger and thumb finger, hold the end part of the thread and the place where the loop has been, where the loop ends, just hold it tightly and keep this thread slightly looser. It need not be very tight, but the place where you're holding the starting part of the loop should be held very tightly. Now you have to take the needle and bring it to the upper portion of the thread, bring it upwards and take it downwards. First you have the needle on the top portion of the thread and you are going to take it back behind, you are going to take it behind the thread, and with the bent portion of the needle you are going to hold it and pull it towards the loop. Now the second loop has been formed using the needle. Now to form the second loop, before forming it, hold the first loop tightly, and now again I'll explain it 2 to 3 times. So you have the needle here, the thread is here. Take the needle, keep it above the thread and bring the needle behind the, take the needle behind the thread and take the bent portion. Now just pull the thread. Okay. Now you have to repeat this. If you go on, you'll become thorough in putting these chain like loops. And I have told you earlier that the zip measurement is very important, because to that length you have to pull the chains, you have to make the chains. And be sure that the chains should not be very tight. You have to hold the tip of the chain after finishing it and pull the loop, pull the thread inside the loop like this. First, for the beginners, it may be difficult, but don't never lose hope and keep trying. It will surely come for you. Make sure that the loops are loose. This I am stressing because the next row that you are going to put, for that the needle has to go inside the chain loops that you are putting in the first row. This is going to be the first row. If you get experienced, you will get the speed. in putting the crochet. See, now we will keep the zip here and measure. See, the length is not yet enough. So put few more loops. Some of them do this by counting. You can do so. See, two more loops. I will reach the okay, now so I have reached the length. Now to go on to the second row, this is like a spinning a dress out of a thread. It's a better option to have the chain loops made more than the length of the zip, so that the remaining portion, even if it is surplus amount of loops are available, even then in that case you can give it to a tailor, or you can stitch by yourself to join the ends of the purse to make the pouch. So make it as lengthy as possible. See, it is more lengthier. Now you can, after making, I'm going to make a crochet like a mat in a square shape, and then I'm going to fold it and attach the ends. You can give to a tailor to attach the ends and attach the zips. If you are aware of sewing techniques, then you can do it yourself. Now this is going to be the turning technique. Please be careful and please take a note of it. Now while turning, and we are going to form another row, so please look properly. Now you're going to take the needle and insert it into the hole here in the previous row. In the first row you're going to insert it. You're already having the needle inside a loop. Now you're going to insert it inside another chain, and now the needle is on the top and the thread is in underneath. Now you take the needle from the top to underneath, and now you get two loops over here. And again you will do the same thing what you did for one loop. Now only difference is that you're going to pull the thread outward from two loops. Now the turning has been done successfully. Now again take a loop. Now just curl the thread over the needle, and then you put inside the chain, second chain, the next chain, and then pull the thread. Now you get three. First take it outside the two loops, and then you will get another two. Take outwards the next two. Let me explain this. This will be little confusing for the beginners. Okay, now we are going to rotate the thread over the needle, and now you see here it's a hole, means it's done. So insert the needle into the next loop. Now pull the thread. Now how many threads, how many strings you will get? Three strings. So take the thread outwards through the first. It may be little difficult, so that's why I said you should keep the loops as loose as possible. Now you have two remaining loops and again pull it. So first you rotate the thread and insert the needle, take out the thread through the loop, and you'll have two, three. You first take the thread through first two loops and again through the next remaining two loops and pull it. See, so this kind of a structure is formed. So first you, the thread will be encircling the needle, and you insert it inside the loop and you pull one thread outwards. Now you will have three strings. Now you have to pull the thread and take it outwards the first two loops, and pull the thread, take it outwards from the next two loops. So this kind of, so this forms a layer of like a, this way people use two needles to sew sweaters also. By this you can make scarf too, whatever you want, handkerchief for your kids, anything. So this is the main process. Just rotate the, encircle the thread around the needle, insert it into the loop, hold it tightly, and now take out the thread to first loop. Now you will have three threads. So from the three strings, first two strings and then the next two strings. So this manner you should continue. See how I'm making encircle the thread. So that's why I told you have to keep the first row. It should be very loose and the loops should be as loose as possible. You're inserting, pulling the thread through the center of the loop. Now you have three loops and you have to pull the thread from first two loops and again from the next two loops. Now encircle the thread, insert it through the loop, take it away from the loop. From the center of the loop you are pulling out the thread. Now you have three. First two you are pulling this way and the next two. So this is how you have to, I think this tutorial will be enough. Now I am going to make it quite faster so that I can show you at least by finishing one row. I have stitched a pouch. You may